In this video, I will show you how to draw this landscape in a tree shape in painterly style. Before we start, you can download the color palette and the brushes I used in the video description below. If you enjoy learning Procreate with me, make sure to check my Patreon, where you can actually access more exclusive tutorials and brush sets. You'll find a link to it below too. Without any further delay, let's begin drawing! I have a vertical canvas that is 2000 by 2500 pixels. In the beginning, I will go and change the background color into the one that comes first in the palette. It's this blue. After that, I will select the color underneath. Let's first draw a tree silhouette. And we will start from painting the tree trunk. For that, I will be using grass blade painterly brush, which is one of the brushes from my botanics set. You will also find it in the bundle for this tutorial. I will make the brush size 15%. Let's first define the shape for the trunk. I will start from the bottom and go up, drawing a curvy line. It will go this way, a bit more up, and from here it will go down on the right. And while going down, it will get wider. This way. Now let's paint inside it. I will start from top and go down. Here we can increase the size to paint faster. It can be 25%. The brush is pressure sensitive, so when we press on the pencil more, the color is getting darker and the lines are getting thicker. I'm making the strokes up and down. Let's finish it at the bottom. And now we can add bigger branches. To make the process a bit easier for you, I've prepared a few stems of tree branches. You can also find them in this set. Let's begin from the first one. I'll make the size 10% and tap somewhere on the empty area. Then I will click on this S icon, select it in freehand mode, click on the arrow and drag it to match with the tree trunk on top. I will adjust its size just a tiny bit. This is fine now. If you can't match it 100%, you can use the brush to fix the transition. I will do it later. Now let's add more branches. So it will be branch number 2 from this list. Here I'll make it 15% and tap somewhere in the empty area on the left side of the trunk. We also need to select it first, because all these elements are located on one layer. After we select it, we can move it and make it match with the tree trunk on the left side. I'll place it this way. we need to keep the lower half of the trunk empty to have some space for the grass and other elements of the landscape. Let's tap one more time with the same stamp, somewhere on the right side from the trunk. I will select it, go to transformation and flip it horizontal first. Then I will place it a bit lower than this branch on the left and make it just a bit smaller. I think this is fine. Let me paint it here straight away, so we don't have this white gap. Finally, let's select the third type of the branch. The size here is 18%, and I will tap this way. Also select it and place this one in this gap between two branches. Let me actually lower its size. And I'll place it this way. Let's step one more time somewhere here. This one will be flipped horizontal. And I will find a good location for it between these two branches. Adjusting the size. Maybe even a bit smaller. All right, this can be fine. Now that we have this base, we can add more smaller branches manually using this grass blade brush. The size here can be set to 10%, and I will first draw a branch in this gap. First not pressing and then applying more pressure. Let me draw one more here. It will first go to the right as a curve and then one more. Now I will make them thicker. As you see, I'm using the same brush to draw these branches as I used to create these branch stems. Let's see what other empty areas we got here. So I will draw something like this on the left side. Then press more. Also here. It's like first I'm sketching it and then adding color, all with the same brush. Let's draw a branch going to the right, also intersecting a big branch here. And one more going this way. Now I will add more color to it. I'm paying so much attention to this tree because it will be in the middle of our composition, so it needs to be pretty. Let me draw a small branch here to balance it on the left side. And the last one will go from here, something like this. And from here, it will make this curve. Now let me finish it by applying the color. From here. And I will make it even thicker. This way. Let me check it. We can also use eraser set to soft brush to fix some of the branches. I think it looks fine now. Now let's create the foliage shape around the tree trunk. For that, I will create a new layer and place it underneath. I will be drawing with the same color. And for the foliage, I will be using foliage painterly brush from the same set. The size is set to 10%. And I will start making the circular moves. The brush is also pressure sensitive, so the color is getting darker when we press more. It also has color dynamics in its settings, so you can see these color variations. Let's go lower at the bottom. And make this shape a bit more curvy as well. So I will paint more on top. Maybe just a couple of strokes on this side. Because normally foliage doesn't have this perfect shape. Now let me go to eraser and set it to the same brush. The size is also at 10%, and I will start erasing it in the middle to keep only the frame. Also here. Alright, now we have the space to paint the landscape. Let me create another layer and place it underneath this one. With the same color and brush, I will define the horizon line. I will just make the brush size a bit lower. It can be 8%. I will draw a line this way. Now I will draw something looking like bush shapes on the sides. Also here. Let me switch to this green color and paint more here. A bit lower than these lines. After that, I will select this dark green and paint more. Also lower. If you ever painted landscape in perspective, you must know that the closer objects are a bit darker and more saturated than the ones located further. So I'm making these strokes darker. After that, I will create a layer above this one, so it will be located between these two. And we will paint the grass. I will start with the lightest shade of green. It's this one. And I will be using thick grass brush. The size is set to 15%. I will make the strokes from left to right and back without lifting the pencil. Creating sort of an arc. After that, I will switch to a darker shade of green and paint more going down. Also to both sides. This row is getting a bit darker. Now let's switch to the next shade of green and paint more. So we are following the same principle. I just want to darken the edges a bit more. So I will make a few strokes on the sides with a darker shade. Finally, I will select the darkest green from here and paint the row of the grass at the bottom. If the grass goes a lot outside your foliage shape, you can use eraser. I will add more strokes on the sides to darken them. Alright, so let me pick a razor, set to soft brush, and I will erase only the tips of the grass blades that go outside my foliage shape. Not more than that. Now it looks fine. Let's paint the sky. I will be doing it on a separate layer that I will create below all layers. I will start with this color in the middle. And for painting, I will be using the same foliage painterly brush that we used for the borders. I'll set it to 10% again and paint here in the middle of this empty area. After that, I will go darker and pick the next color. Painting on top. Then I will select this bluish grayish color and paint on this side, on top area. Finally, I will select the darkest from the blue colors and paint on the lower side, this way. I'm going a bit upper to blend all these colors. I will also paint a spot here on the left side for the sunshine. After that, I will go to smudge tool, which is this finger, and set it to foliage painterly brush. Since this frame layer is located on top, we need to smudge it, otherwise it won't be seen. I will just go making strokes on the edges to blend the colors of this border with the sky and on this side. All right, now let's draw the sun. For that, I will create a new layer above this one and pick this yellowish color. First, I will select monoline from calligraphy set and draw a circle on this light spot, approximately of this size, and I will tap on the canvas to make it perfect. Let's fill it. After that, I will duplicate this one and apply Gaussian blur on one of the layers, around 12%. I will duplicate this blurred layer a couple of times. After that, merge it with the circle. Let's set this layer to soft light. It is barely visible, so we can try to duplicate it. It is already better. Let's try to duplicate it one more time. If it looks a bit too bright, we can lower the opacity of this top layer to 80%. And now this is fine. Well, I think this edge turned a bit too dark. So let me go back here and I will apply more of this color with the foliage painterly this way. Now that's better and the colors look more blended. Since we have the sun, we can also add some highlights on the tree. So I will create a layer above it and clip. I will also select this brown color. And in the brushes, I will pick textured shading brush. Let me go and flip the canvas horizontally. It's only because I prefer painting from the right side. If it's fine for you, you can apply the brush from the left. Just make sure This highlight will be located on the same side as the sun. The opacity of the brush is set to 80% and the size is at 4%. I will start painting on the right side of the tree trunk. If you didn't flip the canvas, it will be left side. So I'll first make a couple of strokes, not pressing on the pencil, and then press more when drawing on the edge. Here I will go up in the same manner, first not pressing and then applying more pressure. Let's draw on this branch. Here I will make the brush size 2% because the shape got smaller. And I'm going up on the right side till the end. We can highlight some bigger branches at the bottom, like this one and here. Here I will highlight it on top. And this one. This is enough. Let me flip it back. To make it look more like a painting, we can apply paper overlay. So I will create a new layer and select this textured paper brush from the bundle. I will pick some shade of gray. Let me put this color in the palette. The brush size is at maximum, and I will paint all over the canvas. After that, I will set the layers mode to overlay. Let me also create a layer right above the background, and I will select this dark green, but not the darkest one. In the brushes, I will pick splash. The size is set to 35% and I'll make a few strokes around the shape. After that, I will set it to overlay. So they got slightly visible. If you are not quite satisfied with the shapes, you can use liquify to fix it quickly. And I think I will add a couple of birds in this empty area. So I will create a layer below the paper overlay and select this dark green color. I will keep them simple and I will be using script brush from calligraphy to paint. The size is at 15%, so I will draw two wings like this and another bird at some angle. Then I will set this layer to soft light, and the birds turned into the shadow and got this texture. Right now our composition is ready. If you enjoyed this video, please give it a thumbs up and don't forget to subscribe. Also, if you share your version on Instagram, please tag me in your post so I can see it. Thank you for watching. I'll see you in the next video.